Hello friends, my name is Ajinkya and I am the Microsoft Python Certified Trainer. So, in the last video session, we will see how we can create a login application with a database. So, in this video tutorial, we will see that how we can insert a record into an Excel file. So, suppose you want to work with the Excel, then there is a module present in the Python, and that module is called as a OpenPY Excel module. Before starting the development, first you need to install the OpenPY Excel module. For this purpose, I am using the PyCharm software, and in the PyCharm software there is a terminal. So there is a terminal. In the terminal, first you install the OpenPY Excel module. So how we can install this? By using the command, that is a pip install OpenPY Excel module. So this is a module that can be used to work with the Excel. So I am already installed this module. Then next step, create a folder. So I am creating a folder at a location C drive with Excel work, and in this folder I am creating a test.xl file, that is a test.xlx file. So this is a requirement, this is a pre-requirement. After installing the OpenPY Excel, then import it. So let's see practically how we can insert a record into an Excel file. So for this purpose, first import the module by using the command, that is a from OpenPY Excel import star. Next, from tkinter import star. Then second, the third module, that is we require to show the messages, that's why I am using the module from tkinter import message box. So these are the modules required to work with our project. So first create a window. So how we can create a window? That is, a window is equal to assign the tk class to it, then window dot main loop. So in this way we first create a window. Let's run the project and see the output. So this is our simple window. So give the title on the window, that is a window dot, there is a method called a title. I am giving the title, that is a registration form. Control the wheel type height of the window, that is a window dot, there is a method called geometry method. I am giving, this is a height and width of the window. So let's run the project and see the output. So this is our window with a title, that is a registration form, and this is a default location of by using the geometry method. So first create a label and entry. So for the demonstration purpose, I am using only two field here. You can use on the basis of, you can use a field as you want. So I am using a field like name and mobile number. So first create a labels and entry widget. So how we can create a label and entry widget and use a grid method to place them in a proper positions. So first create a labels. So how we can create a label? So first I am creating a label, that is first label, that is a, I am giving the variable name as a register label. So there is a class present in the label which is placed on the window. Next property, that is a text. So I am using the text, that is a fill the form. Next property, I am changing the font. That is the font view. I am using the font Arial 15 and it should be a bold. So this label is placed on the window by using the grid method. So register label dot the grid method, it requires two arguments, that is the row at the row position 0 and column position at a 1. So this is a label. Let's run the project. So this is a fill the form. This is the label. Next step, create a label name. That is the name label LPL is equal to label, which is placed on the window, text. Text is equal to enter name. So this is the name. Place it on the window by using the grid method. So name label dot grid method, it require two arguments, that is a row at 1 and column position at a 0. So let's run the project and see. This is a inter name. So in front of inter name we will assign a entry or text box. So how can achieve the task? So let's create a one entry that is called as a name entry. I am giving the variable name as a name entry is equal to, there is a class present entry which is placed on the window, and place the name entry read in front of inter name label, that is a row is equal to row, that is a row is 1, so row is 1 and column is equal to 1. Okay, so let's run. So this is a entry, this is a inter name and this is a entry. Same again, I am creating another entry that is called as a, that is called as a mobile, inter mobile number. So I am copying the piece and paste it. So change the mobile and mobile. So it is placed on the row 2 column 0. So same, I am creating the mobile entry. So mobile entry and place it on the row 2 and column 1. So let's run the project. Just change here inter name, inter. So I am creating these two name, that is a two field. First field is enter the name and second one is the enter the mobile number, and create a one button to submit the result. So button, so giving the name as a submit, button submit. There is a button class is present, which is placed on the window. Text on the button, that is a submit. So this is a parameter, and if you want to provide the width, and using the text, so place it on the window by using grid method, button submit dot. There is a method called a grid method, which is a row 3 and column is equal to 1. So this is the button. Run the project and see the output. So this is a button. Whenever the user submit the result should place it in the Excel file. Okay, so in this way we have to first create a window by providing two field, that is a name field and mobile, and one button. So first create one function, and first create one global variable that is a workbook. I am giving the shortcut as a workbook is equal to, there is a method called load workbook. So what is the, where is my file is present? My file is present at C colon Excel 1. Okay, so copy the same path and paste it. So change the slash as and name of the my file, that is a tester dot excel sx. So this is my file which is already present in the C drive. So this is a file. Load workbook. Second thing, active the sheet. That is a active the workbook. So I am creating the object that is a sheet is equal to workbook dot, there is a method called active method. So our worksheet is now active. Let's create a one function that is a def create a Excel. Okay, so this is a, our first function which can create a Excel and provide some default values. So how we can provide a default values, that is a sheet dot column dimensions, that is of a column dot, there is a, I am providing some default width, that is a 30. Again sheet dot column dimensions of B, column B, it should be width should be also a 30. So I have for 2 feet, that's why I am creating a A and B, that is a 2 column. If you want, if you have a 5 feet, then you have to create a 5 column. I have only 2, that's why I am creating a 2. Second step, create a column headers. So how we can create a column headers? So sheet dot cells of, that is row position 1 comma column 1, and it provides us some value. So I am assigning the first default value, that is the name of column. Second same, that is I am just copying the same thing and paste it. So row 1 column should change, that is the second column, and name, instead of name I am writing here mobile number. So this is my column name. So in this way you can create a column. Yes, so this is a function for creating the Excels. Okay, so another function we have to create here, that is called as the clear fit. Okay, so def clear. So this is a function which clears the entry field. So how we can create an entry field? Check what is the name of our first entry. So our first entry, that is a name entry, this is a variable name, and again mobile entry, these are the 2 entry. So name entry dot delete. If you want to clear the text boxes or entry visit, then this is a method to clear the field. So name entry dot delete starting from 0 up to end. Same, that is a mobile entry also, dot delete starting from 0 to end. Okay, and set the focus on name entry, that is a name entry dot focus. So cursor blink on the name entry. So this is another method to clear the field. The first method, that is a create Excel, second method, that is a to clear the field. Then we required a third method to insert a data into Excel file. So I am creating another function, and that function is called as a insert data. So this is my function name to insert the data into an Excel file. So first to check if the fields are empty, then give the message to the user. So how we can check if the fields are empty? So if name entry dot, this is a method get equal to if empty and mobile entry dot get, this is an empty, then message box dot show info, first parameter that is name on the message, and second parameter please enter information. Okay, if the fields are empty, then it shows the message to the user. Otherwise, insert the data into a Excel file. So how we can insert the data into Excel file? First, we need to create a variable which is called as a max row and max column. So first we assign max row. First we find the max row and max column. That's why I am creating a two variable. That is a first variable is called as a present row. So this is our first variable, and we have to find, that is a sheet dot find the max row. Okay. So second variable I am creating, that is a present column. So sheet dot find the max column. So this is the two variables. First we find. Then next step, get data from entry visit and place it to a particular row. So how we can get a data from entry visit and how we can place in a particular row, particular column or particular row? For this, sheet dot sales of, so sheet dot sales of row is equal to, that is our present row, plus 1. If user insert a record one by one, then it is inserted at a next row. And column is equal to, that is the first dot value is equal to, and this value, that is name entry dot get. When the user enters some text into a name field, then the name entry take this information and place it at that particular column. In same way, you can create a sheet dot sales of row is equal to present row plus 1 comma column is equal to second column and dot value is equal to mobile entry dot get method. So get the data. So in this way you can assign a record at a particular positions. Okay, so I have a two field, that's why I am creating here a two field. If you have a multiple field, then you can create as per your the requirements. So final step, if you get all the data on the record, then when the user submit a result, the result should be placed in the Excel file. So for this you have to save the Excel file, that is a workbook.save. okay, so we have given the same, that is a location, copy and paste it. So I am giving change the slash. I am providing the output dot xlsx. So this is my file name, output dot xlsx. So in this file the result is saved. Okay, so next call the clear function to clear the fault field. Okay, so this is our methods. First method, create a Excel, clear method to clear the field, insert a data into an Excel file. Then go to the button here and call the function that is called as a create Excel. So call the function before the button submit, and on the button submit click event there is a method called command method, and in the command method attach the insert data method to the command property of button. Whenever the user click on the submit button, the data that is insert data, this is a method to insert a data into a Excel file. So in this way you can create a small application to insert a data into an Excel file. So let's run the project. So I am inserting here first. So this is my name, and something this is a mobile number, and when the user submit. Okay, so again I am using another, this is Rohan. So this is something data. Whenever the user click on the submit, this is our file which is present at a location C drive, and output.xlx file. This is our result. When click, so this is our data. So in this way you can insert a data into an Excel file. So this is a very easy step. Okay, I hope you like this video. If you like the video, please like, share and subscribe my channel. Thank you for watching the video.